Hi everybody, and we are back. Today we are going to start on her hair, and we will color that ear ring there. And I believe that I want to actually color it gold, so maybe we should just start with that. Actually, switch that out. I have picked out some colors that we can use for the earring. Hopefully it will make some kind of gold. But when I color gold, I just take a dark brown and then a little bit of a orange and some yellow, because I think that make a good gold color. And usually I put stuff on top of it anyways, so I'm assuming that's in. So I'm not that fussed or worried about getting the correct gold. So that was the dark amber. Put that away. And I will take the pumpkin orange. Is that this one? That is the mineral one. The pumpkin is the slightly darker one. I have quite a long tip today. A little bit more of the orange on the inside there, and some so that it creates a small shadow underneath there. Let me push off those away. Then I have yellow ochre. Yeah, and the dark amber is number 947. The pumpkin orange was 1032, and this is the yellow ochre PC 942. So I'm going over everything that with that yellow, because gold contains a lot of yellow actually, or that is when it is like a yellow gold, because you have white gold and you have a red gold. But so darken up, so let me just stop there. The pumpkin, put that a little bit more orange, to that aside, again going over with the yellow ochre, and then I have actually pulled out the cream, which is 914, and I'm going to soften things out. Still leaving a small part here uncolored, blending everything together with this cream, and I can use the white on top to blend out. Oh, and I have to sharpen that one, so I just got the other day a order from Jackson Art, where I got myself a new like this bullet sharpener, and I just love them. I love how heavy they are and how they feel in the hand. So some white, just blending that out, nothing fancy like that. So that is her gold earring. Where is my little brush so I can. Of course we can, if we want to go, put some gold or yellow glitter gel pen. I don't know if this is a good color or not. Let's just test it. Right. Did not really show that well. So probably won't. No, that won't show at all. Need something darker. So not that one. We have that from the Pentel, which is a really nice, a lot of darker than this one. Putting some down, and oops, I got some in her hair. Try to smoosh it a little bit out without actually smearing it everywhere. it's not that easy, but just putting some of that down, just so it gets a little bit of a sparkle. You see that there? That it sparkles more in real life, of course, because glitter in camera never works the way that you want to. Like that. Then I will put away the cream and the yellow ochre. So we can actually start on the hair, because that will take us a while. For hair, picked out the dark amber 947, chestnut 1081, pumpkin orange 1032, and mineral orange, that is 1033. If you want a more yellowish highlight, you can add that, or you can use beige as a highlight or whatever. And maybe you just don't like this combo, but then you can use this as a base and then play around with it and add in the colors that you like and change it up, because there is really no right or wrong. Just have fun. So I'm just putting some flicks down, and with flicks mean that you're putting the pencil down to the paper, and as you push it up, you also kind of lift it up from the table like this, doing some swoosh motions. And you can do the same thing down boards like that. That is flicking, but it's not that important to do the flicking or put so much job in flicking. It's just make some thin lines. So I started out with the, to switch that again, the dark amber, putting that in the top and the bottom of this hair. Then I take the chestnut, pumpkin orange. I'm not filling every part of that space. I will zoom us in when we have done this one. I just want to show you first how I like to do this. So this is the mineral orange, the lightest one, like that. Then I do everything one more time, starting out with the amber, darken up that darkest part, and take the chestnut. Then, because that is kind of a darker red brown, taking this over the dark amber and pumpkin orange, and kind of pulling that further down, sort of. So that one, this is the pumpkin. Bring that up like that. Then I take the mineral and just add that where I think that the lightest areas should be. That. So I have left some parts uncolored. So this is kind of the color, and hopefully you haven't fleshed out totally. So this is kind of what I'm going for. So I want her to be a redhead. So I will, we can actually start up there and take this big part, but then I kind of want to turn it around, because I think that, or I find it easier when I'm working sideways when I do this. And we will zoom you guys in. Let me see. Hopefully it won't be too grainy. And I'm sorry that she has to be sideways, but in order for me to be able to work. So I'm starting again with darkest, the dark amber, and I'm just taking lines from the middle here where that here starts, taking some up, the same from the bottom down here, not that many. Now we have something happen here, so we can put one or two dark ones maybe beneath there, just because Jasmine has thrown in those, they're not folds, but I don't know how I will explain what they are. The parts in the hair that is going or making movements. Taking my pencil, this is the chestnut, from the starting point up there, and drawing my lines over the dark amber and a little bit out like that. See, I don't worry about this flickering. I hear so many say that they can't master flickering. Well, don't worry, just make thin lines. Again, going over from the, actually from this starting point, the darkest areas, and working my way up. And I kind of lost those dark areas there, but we can bring them back if I want to. Then I take the mineral orange, and now I'm just continuing those like that. Again, starting with the darkest, the dark amber, making lines from here as well, changing that up, taking the chestnut, getting some lines there, going over everything again. I'm putting more lines down this second time than I did the first time. Then I take the pumpkin, those areas there are supposed to be darker, so let's just try to get them, some of them back by using this chestnut, a little bit that. But if we lose them, that is okay, because the same from the top down, just making a lot of lines. What is important is that I'm making the lines the same direction that the hair goes. So, and then I switch over now to the mineral orange. So here, the hair goes from here and going down there. So I'm putting my lines in the same direction that it goes. Putting some more of this lightest color on the outer edges where we missed. Because when I'm doing this, I can actually miss some parts like that. I think I want to have it darker, so going back in with that pumpkin, just pulling some of that darkest red, that darkest orange, my ginger color, pulling it down, Now some of these highlights are too big and too bad, so I'll just take my mineral orange and go over them like that. Of course I can go in with some yellow if I want that. I can show you how that translates. I put in just some yellow like here and there, on that, maybe on that highlight as well. That is this is the yellow ochre, same we used for the earring. Yellow ochre was 942. We can put in some yellow. I could have put in other colors as well, depending on the surrounding. So this is how I color here, more or less. Nothing special. I'm trying every time, or whatever I color, I try to make it kind of easy and fun, and I hope that you people do the same and stop overthink things like that. Yeah, we can we could of course change to another color in the front down here, and maybe that beret, but yeah, I don't know. Now let's stick to what we got now. We can keep working on that little line there. I just do the same again. I try to keep a fairly pointed pencil on when I do here. Maybe I actually should turn her again. And I'm so sorry if you are getting motion sick, but this is the way I have to do it for me to be able to color it. I'm just making some dark lines here, because this is in the shadow, so this will be quite dark. So I'm just putting in that dark amber down there. Take my chestnut on this hair that is here. Oh my god, that sounds silly. Here I will not use the lightest orange or lightest ginger color, and that way will automatically make it a bit darker than the top here. Yeah, we won't leave as many highlights either. That again, that darkest. Around her. Place there. And we have the chestnut. I'm not flickering or do that as much here. Some, but because this is in the shadows, we won't see single here anyways. So this is the, that was the pumpkin orange. Come over that. That, so that automatically makes it darker than the top here, but this again has to be quite light. But we will have some shadow here because of that beret going over there. I think that is our called beret, making some single lines. Push guys up a little bit. Trying to make them move the same way that the hair grows. A couple up there, like that. And here we have another one of these. And this is the chestnut. So hopefully we can do it this way. Going over the burnt and going to move the direction that the hair grow. Need some around here. So there. Like that. And today, all of a sudden, everybody, or not everybody, my son is still home, but the rest of the house was supposed to do something, like after he is out fishing, and daughter is seeing a friend. Nikolai went out with one of his friends as well, and I was suddenly more or less home alone, just me and my son. Now my son is in his room, and he don't nag anyways. After all, he is 24, so he, yeah. So then I was like, oh my god, so the house is gonna be quiet. And I was like, oh my god, yes, 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 I'm gonna turn on some music and diamond paint. And I was like, oh no, I have to record this and actually take advantage of that. When finally is some peace and quiet here. I lost some of that highlighter. Again, just my dark umber. I'm trying to stick to English, but sometimes I hear some Norwegian birds coming out trying to hide them, but it's not that easy. Chestnut. A little bit up there. I have lost my tip. So you can see now I don't have that crisp, or those crisp lines. See, this is the pumpkin. Which I need to shorten it up just a little bit. Prismacolors are good for the blending, but things where you need a sharp point, like here, they're not that good. Like that. Blending it out there. Let's see. Now I should use the lightest one, which is the mineral. I'm just sharpening it a little bit. I don't like to sharpen away all of my pencil. That. Maybe I actually should add that yellow to my list. I think we and do that, or the cream maybe. This is the cream color, just that really didn't do anything. The yellow one was much better. The yellow ochre, isn't that? Yeah. Yellow ochre. That's going over that. Because I don't want white highlights in this here. I want them to be light. It's totally white. So I'm gently putting that yellow on top so that it kinda yeah, kinda yellows it up. Yeah, can I don't know. It's hard to explain, but hopefully you can see what it does. Like that. And if I feel like I lost some of the highlights there, we can erase, like I have my little mono eraser here. We can erase some parts, or we actually can go in with a white gel pen, something I often do anyways, just to get back some of those really bright highlights. Taking my white pencil, just put that on top, because when I have erased, we have a bit of a not clean paper, but more of that paper underneath. I'm just shaping those a little bit, like that maybe. So we can fix stuff. We just start again with that little bad idea, that this is the dark umber. Putting that down. Now I can't flicker when things are this small. So I'm just putting down the shadow color where things meet and is on top of each other. Like that. Maybe a little bit around there. This is small. Chestnut. Because you can try to make some flicks, but I find that to be quite hard when you have a very small area or don't have that much space to work on. So I'm just putting that chestnut in the upper and bottom part of each swirl. And again, this is then the pumpkin orange, going over there, putting that down. And so now I'm putting some flicks in, just like one maybe on each, just to make an illusion of here. Bottom and top, and a little bit goes or down. Bottom and top, and some. It's the bottom, and then a top, and bottom, and just make a little swirl. Top and bottom, and separating them, but that is so small. Then I have my mineral. I'm just closing that white gap, but I still don't cover it completely like that. can use some yellow to that on my cover completely. Maybe I want it to be a little bit darker in the crevices or the that is kind of a thing that you that color this have to choose for yourself and see how dark you want to go. And a general rule is that you can never go too dark. So when you think you are dark enough, you can add a little bit more. Skipping the pumpkin and doing the mineral orange here. Just like that. So that was that small parade. You see that this part of here is coming out there. So I will not use the well, I'm flipping my paint, that the dark umber right at the back there, or I can maybe to try to separate it a little bit from the front parade. But as this is a part that is kind of coming into the light and it's supposed to be a little bit further, I start with the second dark color, the chestnut. I need a little bit more of a point. Again, traditional colors are not really good for here. Just getting some single hairs, kind of drawing them in like that. Then I have the pumpkin orange, which was my darkest orange. Like that. Then the mineral, the lightest. Use that yellow as well, just to go or blending that in. Yeah, I like that because it kind of sticks out from the background. But of course, we haven't colored that back part, but we should do now. I guess that part is that little thing there, that is skin. So I will just take some peach and just put it in. It is so small, so that is, yeah, that have to be take my dark amber right there. So this is going to be a shadow pulling up here. And of course we have a red, so that part will be dark as well. And down here, because it is behind her shoulder, and then I will flick some here. Because we will flick down there, putting in some. Oh, I'm having wrong pencils in my hand. There. And the chestnut. So I'm just making lines with that. I can go over that at the back there with that chestnut as well. Just put in some lines from that chestnut down there. Maybe putting some dark there, the dark amber. Again, the pumpkin orange. Just coloring that normally at the back there. Putting some lines there. Flicking from the top and then flicking from the bottom. And a little bit of that mineral so that they kind of meet. I'll just use that mineral. It won't be that much of that at the back. So this is the chestnut. Again, that one will have a kind of a shadowy effect. To darken up that dark amber, darken that up with my chestnut so that it doesn't look as down, but more reddish. Then the pumpkin orange. Just flicking that in. And I'm twisting, I don't know if you are able to see, but sometimes I stop and then I kind of turn my pencil like this. That is so I can use the sharp point that I have. I'm doing a couple of helix, and when I feel like I have lost the point, I'm just turning it a little bit so that I can get back some of that that point like that. And let's, I shouldn't move that too much, keep on working our way down here. This is the amber. Just putting some small flicks in there. We can put a couple of more there. Then the chestnut. She starts. This part actually starts up here. So I'm just covering with that. Putting some flicks. Little bit further up from the amber, but this part should be dark as well. Then we have the pumpkin. Starting to be tricky because I want to turn my page and I'm really trying not to. Again with my chestnut. Just darken up some of those parts that we have underneath there. And this. Again, pumpkin. So this is very, very repetitive, and that is why hair takes just as long as skin, sometimes even longer. Just pulling some of this further up like that. Then this is the mineral orange. Pulling that over from the top. to the middle and over the middle, and from the bottom up to the middle, and pulling that a little bit over the middle like that. I'm just going over with this mineral that is the my lightest, just to make things a little bit more, I don't know, so that they are together, that it is kind of the same here. So now we have done all of this part, and we are at 41 minutes already. So of course, what I did on this side, I'm so sorry for that camera. What I did on this side, I will just repeat on this side, starting out with that big area first here, and then I will take the front part here and work my way down. And the braid that goes further down on her, I will do the same. So now she's really thick hair and really long hair. Let me see if I can get all that in there. So what I did here is what I will continue. Now you can, when you are new, I suggest to go like one by one, doing them one by one, and work your way down. You can even work like one here and one there, and just as long as you keep the lines in the direction of the hair, you are fine. Or of course you can, and many likes to do that, you can go first in with all the shadowed areas, putting them like there, and just picking them out first, also like that, and do it like color by a color. When I started out doing here, I thought that it was actually easiest to do one by one, because I kind of lost track of where I was when, and it was hard to see all or know where all the shadows were supposed to be when I kind of did everything at once. So doing one by one was a big help for me. So that is just a tip. So I will color the rest of the hair off camera. Then eyebrows. I always forget that. Same colors as the hair. Darkest in the on each end of the eyebrow. That and there, chestnut a little bit further in, same there, not that much. Maybe I should zoom this in. Let's see, where did I actually put my coffee? I'm out of coffee. Yeah, that is why I have to stop this, because I need coffee. So my chestnut, the pumpkin, again from the ends, working my way back in like that, and then this is the mineral orange, like that. I think I'm skipping the dark umber for my next one, because I already have it dark enough. Like that. Pumpkin. Oh yeah. That. Some little bit there. Now these are really thin. I bad those. This is my lightest one. This is the mineral. For making them more bushy. Can I zoom? Let's see how close can we get them. Oops. There. We can try to make them more bushy. We have a small pen. Again, this is just the regular pilot pen. So this is a 01 that you can see here. So, and I will just try to hopefully not push it away. Come on, don't give me that pulse. Are you going to pulse me every time I'm moving this one? Just making small lines up on this one. Really, really tiny lines. I'm so scared of overmaking or giving her too much of a lines. Oops. Like that was a little bit too much because they... Yeah. I don't want her looking like a wildling. And I'll just take my Sakura Jelly Roll and find the 05, the thinnest one, because I really need a really, really, really thin line here. And just dotting that in for highlights in the eyebrows. They were a little bit too strike white there. Okay, take my. I can actually take that yellow and tone those down a little bit. I don't quite know how visible that actually is. And I lost the highlight again here. Good thing with the gel pens is that you can scrape it off if you have too much. And you can kind of start over. Well, she... Yeah, I don't want it to have that too bushy. So I'm taking my peach and I will go in with that and try to tone some of that down just a little bit. I'm being gently or gentle, I mean. Put that right in. And I should stop fussing with this, or else I will just make it worse. Doesn't look that bad when you look at it on a distance. Just putting some orange in there. Well, at least she have bad eyes now, and she. As she is a pirate, I'm sure that she doesn't pluck them too often. Something like that. I think so. Let us zoom you guys out. Again, like that maybe. Push her up so you can see. Yeah. So. This is what we got so far. I think that she will be looking awesome. And we will get the blue ocean at the back and this kind of blue sky, but we will have clouds as well. And I think that this is the sand, so that will be some kind of a sandy color, beige, ochre maybe. Let's see, at least with the blue ocean and the blue sky thingy, and I think that her ginger hair will just pop. So next time we will be coloring the background. So I hope that you all are staying safe and healthy and everything, and I don't really have anything else to say. Thank you all so much for watching at this episode. There is Molly. I love you all, so I'll see you all later. Bye.